But he did that because his mother, Rivka, told him that he's the one who will inherit. So he, obedient child, followed the mother. He followed the mother. And he had, the life was not easy for him because he will have always to fight in order to take the, to keep his position.
Ah, okay, yeah, to be a...
Yeah, it's a fight. It's
of course a fight.
A
fight, yeah.
It was a spiritual fight because always the higher the call, the higher the struggle.
Yeah.
And he has to stand, and it's only when the Malak came, he wrestled again with the Malak the whole night until he became Israel. He who prevailed with El.
Overcomer.
Yeah, he's an overcomer because he overcome this only that, then his name was changed. And he can enter Canaan
before
he fight. His last battle was with Esau. And he prevailed. He prevailed because he had these promises. And this is what we have to understand when things are very hard. Like we have now, you know, this time with this, we have not to move. We have to keep the promise of Elohim and to trust Elohim. No matter. No matter what's happened. 1,000 on your side, Miriam at your right hand. You just trust Jehovah. How? I don't know. We don't know. We don't have to know. You understand? Esau didn't know. He didn't know. He went. He, Elohim tell him to leave Laban. And after that, he has an encounter with Esau. And he went to pray. And ask him to help him. But Elohim told him to go. So, no, usually, he should have said, okay, Elohim told me it's no problem. But he has to battle against his own flesh.
Yeah, flesh. The fear of that.
His own flesh. He has to battle. And he went into prayer.
Yeah.
He reminded Elohim of the promises.
It is our...
He reminded Elohim of the promises. This one, our attitude is always so. Remember. Remember your promise you did to Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov. To give them the land. You see?
You see, the problem is our... flesh.
Yeah,
this is what we have to overcome because we have already the promises of Elohim, but we need to overcome this flesh to overcome with the fear of death.
Shall, this is why the words take a new dimension. Shall tell us the promise of Elohim are yes and amen.
Wow.
Yes and amen. Is there is no change with Elohim. He didn't change his mind. Okay? So we follow the way of Yeshua. Because Yeshua shows the way.
Mm-hmm.
He shows the way to go, to walk. And we have to trust. We have to trust Yeshua that he shows the good way. So this is how we walk. And here we have a very good example in the life of Yaakov, who never went into temptation when Laban cheated him, you know, and tried to make everything working for nice. But Yaakov kept the goal. He kept the goal, the promise he did with his mouth. I will work 7 years. I will work 7 years. And then he cheated him when he said him to work 6 years. He keep the way. He keep the way. At the end, it is Elohim who told him to go, not him. And he went. He went, and every time he has to wrestle. Because after that, he wrestled with Laban. Laban came against him. And when Laban was finished with Laban, Esau came. He was wrestling again. You understand? But his name with Esau, after Laban, his name was changed to Israel. It was finished for Esau. It was finished. No more. And this is to become Israel. It's also to be overcomer.
Mm-mm.
We become Israel. We are not Israel. We become Israel.
Yeah.
Because Israel is spiritual.
Spiritual.
We become Israel. By our walk, when we walk, we become Israel. We need to, you can be today an Israelite and not to be Israel. You understand? If you live in Israel, you have a passport, Israelite.
That is earthly.
But if, yeah, if this is an earthly document.
Yeah, it's nothing to
but
do to the
to become Israel
of Elohim. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's nothing to do.
Yeah.
You must be, there is a rule from Elohim.
Yeah, yeah. Today you be an Israeli, but you are not an Israelite.
Mm.
You see?
Of course, yes.
So, that's the difference. That's and awesome. This is why we have to learn to walk. And they explained that in the first book of Zion, that you have two kind of person. Those who we hold fast on the promise like Jacob, and those who will not, because of trouble, because, you know, the prayer not answered. I pray, but no answer. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We keep going because Elohim wants to test his children.
Yeah.
You know, it's not a cheap thing to enter the kingdom. It's not. It's not. Yeshua paid the full price.
Yeah, yeah.
He gave his life. He paid the. There is no higher price. Mm. Yeshua gave his life.
But through him, this is why we have access to the Father.
Yeah, but this is. I don't want to point that. I want to say that if Yeshua gave his life, we must be ready also to follow the way, and not to consider our life better, but to say, okay, everything is in the hand of Elohim, you know, and to trust Elohim. The result that was for Yeshua was the resurrection.
Mm.
What's the resurrection? He was struggling. He was struggling in the night. Mm-hmm. He knew now is the time to come. He was struggling. He was hoping that the thing can change. But it's nevertheless, thy will be done. And this is, but he went through. And he had the victory. The victory was the resurrection. So if we want to go there, we have to go and to work and to trust Jehovah, no matter what.
Mm.
To trust Jehovah. And this is what we have to emulate in every one of us in our small group, to encourage one another. You know?
This is so, where you encourage one another.
Yeah. This is.
Because sometimes there are some.
No, everyone goes through a challenge.
Everyone can pull one another. Mm. Yeah.
Well,
this is what Charles said, to encourage one another, because the sin is, the temptation is there.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's very interesting.
This is why we need one another as a building stone of Elohim, to hold one another, to join one another.
Yes.
These are our, you know, our strength.
Yeah.